Class 5, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 9, sense organs. So first of all, here we will discuss what is sense organ, then we will discuss about the sense organs in detail. So first of all, the organs that keep us in touch with our surroundings and with our body, these organs are called sense organs. Like the sense organs of our body are eyes, ears, the nose, tongue and skin. These are the sense organs of our body. So the sense organs can be defined as the organs that keep in touch with our surrounding and also with the body. These organs are called sense organs, and we have mainly 5 sense organs. So the sense organs of our body are the eyes, the ears, the nose, the tongue and the skin. So these are the main 5 sense organs of our body, and through these sense organs we perceive the sensation of light, sound, smell, taste and touch. Like the eyes, it gives us the sensation of light or vision, we can see. The ears, it is giving us the sensation of sound, we can hear. And the nose is giving us the sensation of smell, we can smell the odor or the things, whether it is good or bad. And the taste, that is done by the tongue. Tongue gives the sensation of taste, we can taste the thing, whether it is salty or sweet or bitter. And the skin gives us the sensation of touch, whether an object is hot or cold. So these are the sense organs, and this gives the sensation of light, sound, smell, taste and touch. So now we will discuss about the all the sense organs in detail. So first of all, we will discuss about the eyes. So the eyes, these are known as the organ of sight, means eyes help us to see. Eyes give us the sensation of light, it helps us to see and recognize. So that is why eye is known as the organ of sight. It is situated in a depression in the skull. There is a depression in the skull that is called orbit. So it is situated in the depression in the skull named as orbit. And it is circular in shape, somewhat it is circular in shape, and it is protected by dust particles and other foreign bodies by eyelids and eyelashes. We are having eyelids and eyelashes in our eyes, that is protecting the eye from the dust particles. You can see the eye, as you can see, this is the shape of the eye. It is somewhat circular in shape, and it is protected by the eyelids and eyelashes. We are having hair in our eyes. You are seeing that upper hair and down some hair are there, that is known as eyelashes, that protects the eyes from the dust particles and other foreign bodies. And it is situated in the depression in the skull that is called orbit, and it is circular in shape. And if you will see the parts of the eyes, then human eye can be differentiated into 3 cords. There are 3 cords, like outer, middle and inner. You can see this is the outer layer, then middle layer, and then inner layer is there. So there are 3 coats are present. The outer coat is known as sclera. So the outer coat, which is present at the outside out of the 3 coats, that is known as sclera. And the cornea, so here this is sclera, and then here it is cornea. So this is our outer coat, and in the middle coat is made up of iris. And choroid. This is our choroid, this is iris. This is the middle coat, and then the inner coat, that is made up of retina. So 3 coats are there in human eye. Human eye is differentiated into 3 coats. Outer is composed of sclera and cornea. Middle one is composed of choroid and iris, and then the inner coat is composed of retina. So these are the 3 coats of the eye. So here you can see in the center of the iris. So the iris or the choroid, the middle coat is coming like this, and here it is known as iris. And there is a opening. There is a small opening here in the middle at the center, that is called pupil. This opening is called pupil. This pupil controls the amount of light entering the eyeball. When we are switching on the light or we are getting the sunlight, the amount of light entering the eyeball, that is controlled by the pupil. Pupil controls the amount of light entering the eyeball. So the color of the eye is due to the pigment present in iris. So here some pigments are present in the iris. So due to that, the color of the eye is also reflected according to the pigment which is present in the iris. And behind the iris there is a biconvex lens in our eyes. So behind the iris, here we can get a biconvex lens, that is called eye lens. That is known as eye lens. So these are the part of the eyes. Now we will see how the function is going on or how we are able to see the things. So the lens of the eye, here the lens of the eye, they focuses the light rays on retina. So this is the inner coat which made up of retina. So the lens, it focuses the light rays on the retina. Pupil regulates the amount of light entering into the eye, how much amount of light is required, so that is regulated by the pupil. The lens of the eye focuses rays coming from an object on the retina. So suppose we are trying to see an object, so the lens of the eye, that focuses the rays which is coming from that object on the retina, and from the retina the sensation of the images are carried to the visual area of the brain. So first of all, we are recognizing things with the help of the brain. So brain is for all the functions, brain is required. So first of all, the lens is lens of the eye, they are focusing the rays that is coming from the object on the retina. The retina sending the sensations of the images to the visual area of the brain. The visual area of the brain interprets the sight and make us know what the object is. So that is why how the human eye works. So first of all, the lens of the eye, it focuses light rays on the retina. Then pupil regulates the amount of light that is entering to the eye. The lens of the eye focuses the rays coming from an object what we want to see on the retina. It focuses the rays, and from the retina the sensation of the images are carried to the visual area of the brain. So the visual area of the brain then interprets the sight and it tells us that what is the object, and we are recognizing or we are interpreting or we are telling or we are getting to know what the object is. So the human eye is differentiated into three coats or three sides are there, that is outer coat, middle coat and inner coat. Outer coat is made up of sclera and cornea. Middle coat is made up of iris and choroid, and the inner coat is made up of retina. And it is the human eye is circular in shape and protected from dust particles and other foreign bodies by eyelids and eyelashes. Then the pupil, it controls the amount of light entering to the eyeball, and there is a lens behind the iris. Behind the iris there is a biconvex lens that is called eye lens. So eye is known as the organ of sight. It helps us to see the object, it helps us to see the beautiful nature. So we should take care of the eye. The proper care should be taken of the eye so that eye should not get damaged or it should not have any problem in visualizing any object. We should take care of the eye. The eye should be washed with the clean water, and we should not read in dim or bright light. That should be avoided. We should not read in too much dim and too much bright light. We should not look directly to the sun continuously. We should not look to the sun while reading or writing. We should not sit facing the direct source of light. The light should be come from the back or left side. Occasional rest should be given to the eyes when they are used for a prolonged period. When you are doing something, then you should give the rest to the eyes. And reading while traveling should be avoided. Never look at the sun directly with your eyes. So some steps, some points we have to remember. We have to take care of the eyes because it is a very important organ of our body. It is an organ of sight. It helps us to see and visualize. So we should take care of our eyes. So we should, first of all, we should wash our eyes with the clean water. So the eye should be washed with the clean water. We should not read in dim or bright light, and we should not read while traveling. While traveling, reading should be avoided. Then when we are reading or writing, we should not sit facing direct source of light, or we should not look at the sun directly with our eyes. Then occasional rest should be given to the eyes when they are used for a prolonged period. So these are the few care that we have to take of for the eye. So this is all about the eye, the sense organs. First of all, the sense organ, we have discussed about the eyes, so you can read in your book. Next class we will discuss about the ears.